Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to Hope at Home. This is the 9th episode in a row. We're still here. We're still playing for you every night. Christoph Israel on the piano and me, Daniel Hope. Tonight's episode is dedicated to all those artists out there right now and also artists in the past who resisted categorization. Artists that went that extra mile, that thought and acted outside of the box and in a sense created a revolution of their own. We began tonight with two pieces by Eric Satie. In fact, works usually for solo piano, his Nyosien, number one, and the Gymnopédie, number three, that Christoph and I decided to play for you. Why did we choose Satie? Well, in some cases, he was one of the most unusual and revolutionary musicians of his time. Born in 1866, he not only composed music, he wrote texts, he inspired so many different musical movements, later Dadaism, if one thinks of that, and all sorts of things. He was unconventional, and he went his own path. And that's something that we're going to celebrate today, artists going their own path. A big thank you to everybody who's been writing in. The comments are increasing and extremely moving and touching. The feeling that we are able to connect around the world to people, that people can connect back to us, and that we can use this time here in my living room to share emotions and to maybe forget about what's going on in the world, at least for a few minutes. I'd like to play a couple of videos that we've received, three extremely different videos. The first one comes from the great Simon Halsey. He is one of the finest choir directors in the world, and he sent this video to us.
Hi, I'm Simon Halsey, and I'm speaking to you from Birmingham, England. I'm a choir conductor, and life's a bit bleak at the moment because, of course, as you can imagine, I need my wonderful singers to make music with. I have got time for planning and some blue sky thinking how life might be better in the musical world in the future. But if I'm honest, I wish I could make a bigger contribution. It's a bit late, I guess, to train to be a doctor or a nurse, but oh, how I wish I was part of the health service.
Thank you very much indeed, Simon Halsey. We received overnight at least 15 or 20 messages from doctors and nurses who watch this program, and a big thank you to everybody who's out there saving lives right now. Also, I don't know how you feel, but after just these 9 days, and for us 2 weeks before that in quarantine, the feeling some of us are getting a little bit stir crazy seems to be circulating around the internet, not being able to see one's friends or one's loved ones. And two close friends of ours, they're very well-known television actors here in Germany, Jessica Ginkel and Daniel Felo. And I was speaking to them yesterday and asking them, what does their day look like right now? You know, being at home with kids all the time. And they sent me the following video. I could relate certainly to that. Jessica Ginkel and Daniel Felo, stay safe, stay calm, and I hope to see you again soon. And we've had floods and floods of videos of people making music at home, and I wanted to share a really beautiful video from two young ladies, Leah and Sarah.
We're Leah and Sarah.
We're 16 and 14 years old and we live in Germany, in Ostfriesland. We really like to play our harps to spread happiness.
Thank you.
Herzlichen Dank an Leo und Sarah für dieses wunderbare Video und natürlich für diese Freude an Zusammenspiel. Thank you very much indeed for sending that video. We're now going to continue with music and another major composer and artist, somebody who really, in a sense, changed the course of music history, Arnold Schoenberg. And this is not perhaps the Schoenberg that you know. This is an early piece written in 1893 when he was still working for a bank in Vienna. And when he was, in a sense, a sponge, picking up different compositions that were around and making his own pastiche of them. This is a short piece for violin and piano by Arnold Schoenberg. Was a short piece for violin and piano by Arnold Schoenberg, written in 1893, one of his earliest works. At the time, he was still trying to earn a living in a bank. He became very frustrated with that and gave it up at the suggestion of his only teacher, Zemlinsky, and went on to change music history by creating what's known as the Second Viennese School. And one of his pupils was the great Alban Berg. And we're now going to play a selection of songs written between 1900 and 1905, Jugendlieder, or youthful songs by Alban Berg, which very much depict the Vienna of the time, the fin du siècle of Vienna.
Thank you.
If you're just joining us, this is Hope at Home, live from my living room in the middle of Berlin, Christoph Israel and me, Daniel Hope, bringing you music today dedicated to artists out there who have throughout history resisted any form of categorization. Those were four songs by Alban Berg, the Viennese composer, written at the turn of the last century. Magnificent pieces. From there, both Berg and Schoenberg, who we played earlier, went on to completely put the world of music on its head with a whole different sense of style, of phrasing, of structure. And from that moment on, music was never to be the same again. Today, I'm very honored to have an extraordinary guest here. He is known for many, many talents as a director, as a visual artist, as a writer, as an actor. There is no end, in fact, to his talent and to his inspiration. And in fact, we met a few years ago when a mutual friend of ours, a wonderful person, brought us together. And Robert Wilson invited me to be a part of a huge production that he put together, a radio play called The Tower of Babel. And it was the most extraordinary experience for me, being close to him, working with him, and with a whole team of different actors and musicians on this really very unique piece. And since then, we've been looking for a chance to somehow connect again. And because of this crisis, because of the fact that we're all here and we're all at home, Mr. Wilson, who would not usually have been in Berlin, is stuck here, unable to return to the United States. And that same very, very special friend called me and told me that he's here and suggested we might get together. So I said we have a little television show, and it's a much smaller venue than he's used to, but we, of course, would be honored if he came, and he has agreed. So we've been thinking for the last day or two about what we could do, and I had the idea perhaps he could read some text, but in true Robert Wilson style, he's written his own text, especially for today, and he asked me to select the music to go with it. So I thought long and hard, what could we do and what could we play? And I came up with Arvo Pärt, a composer that we both know and love and respect greatly. He lived in Berlin for quite some time, and Robert Wilson and Arvo Pärt came together in 2015 for Adam's Passion, the most extraordinary amalgamation of two musical minds and two great worlds. And so I thought we would provide the music in the form of Spiegel im Spiegel, a piece by Arvo Pärt from the 1970s, which is called Mirror Within the Mirror, and Robert Wilson, in a separate room, at the same time, would be reading text for you. So this is a world premiere by the three of us. And on another note, I heard this morning the sad news that Ellis Lewis Marsalis Jr., one of the great, great jazz musicians, the patriarch of jazz, passed away sadly yesterday night. And he really resisted any kind of categorization. He's also the father of some of the greatest jazz musicians in the world, Wynton Marsalis, Branford Marsalis, Jason Marsalis. And so we wanted to dedicate this piece to his memory. This is Spiegel in Spiegel with text read by Robert Wilson.
There is that, that is that. There are, there is that, is that, is that. And that it is. This is this. And this is that is. Is that. That is what it is. This is hers. This is his. And this is ours. That is that. And that is what it is. So be it. Exactitude of things. And so be it. Stay home. Stay together. People's lives first. Stay home. Stay together. Feeling of community. Stay home. Together. Reassess the silence. Families take care of each other. Stay home. Stay together. Solidarity. Put people's lives first. Stay home. Stay together. There. Let us make. Okay. Mask. Let us make mask. Okay. This time is the time to do it. Make mass together. This is the time. This is a time to help one another. Okay. Okay. Let us just do it. Let us make mask and help one another. Exactly, making mask. This is the moment for unity. Let us make mask of unity. For unity. Okay. Let us show unity. A unity. This is the time to help one another. Exactly. This is the time to show unity. Yes, we can. Okay. Mask of unity. There. There. Okay. There. There. Okay, masked together. Stay home. Stay together. Take care of each other. What seemed impossible is now inevitable. Our world will be different. Together, apart, brings us closer. Stay home. Oddly, being apart brings us closer. Stay home. Stay together. And the rest is silence.
That was Robert Wilson. At Hope at Home in my other room next to my living room, reciting text which he specially wrote for today, music by Arvo Pärt, the piece Spiegel in Spiegel played by Christoph Israel and by myself, Daniel Hope. It was, in a sense, something we created for this moment, which we decided to call Stay Home. We hope very much that you've enjoyed today's performance. We'll be back again at the same time tomorrow. That's 6 p.m. Berlin time, 12 noon New York time, and 9 a.m. Californian time. And again, to my friend Koji, who's watching in Tokyo, thank you very much. Tomorrow night, my guest will be the singer-songwriter Felix Räuber. I hope very much you can join us. Bye-bye.